The state of Rajasthan in India has a body of myths and stories that are transmitted orally from one generation to another through a kavadiya using kavad, a portable shrine. These oral traditions serve as a medium for evolving, storing, and then transmitting knowledge, art, and ideas from one generation to the other. The kavad tradition is approximately 400 years old, although like several oral traditions in India, its origin is associated with mythology. The stories from the Rigveda, epics such as Mahabharata and Ramayana, are told along with caste genealogies and stories from the folk tradition. Since early times, they have been recited on both religious and secular occasions. The oral tradition of Kavad is integrally associated with the three communities, that of the Sutars, the carpenters who make the Kavad boxes, the Kavadiya Bhats who recite the stories, and the Jajmans who are the patrons. The Kavad is made by the Sutar community in Basti village of Rajasthan, which is 25 km from the district headquarters of Chittorgarh. The Kavadiya Bhats are from Marwar, Jodhpur, Chittorgarh, and bring the Kavad to their respective patron houses in Rajasthan. The Kavadiyas ask the carpenters for specific, personalized Kavads to be made for the stories that they will share concerning the history of Jajman's family as well. The Kavadiya Bhat takes the sacred Kavad to his Jajman's house for recital and receives donation in return. The tradition of Kavad Bhatna begins with the introduction of the Kavadiya, the storyteller. He introduces himself, his village, and what story he is going to present. The Kavadiya squats on the ground, holding the Kavad in his lap, lights the incense sticks, says a small prayer, and begins the narration by pointing at the images on the Kavad with a peacock feather most of the time, or sometimes directly with his fingers. As the stories are told, the panels are opened one after the other, and more paintings are seen, and then they are further narrated. The storyteller gives us an overview of the stories on the panel, introducing all the characters. After making the general introduction, he returns to each image and tells the story in detail. As several stories are associated with the same character, he may use the same image to tell a different story each time. There is also a tiny drawer at the bottom where the viewers are expected to drop the coins towards the storyteller as his fee. At the end of the telling, the devotees offer food, flowers, and gifts and are blessed in return. This blessing ensures them a place in heaven and immortality. It is believed that the audiences become the pilgrims as they listen to the priest of Kavad who takes them on a journey through time and space. The first stage of making the Kavad is making the wooden frame. It has almost 12 to 16 panels on wooden pivots and metal hinges. They are made from soft neem wood or the wood of the mango tree. These are further processed and painted using natural dyes. The natural dyes are mixed with a solution of tree resin, which acts as an adhesive to make a color palette of white, red, blue, yellow, green, and black. The women in the house help in mixing these colors with the resin. Once the mineral colors are prepared and the wooden structure is given the base color, the artist outlines the figures using a fine brush. At present times, the natural dyes are replaced by artificial colors available in the market. The traditional Kavads always had a red background. However, artists use other colors nowadays to attract attention. The colors are applied one by one in layers, each layer adding the next stage of depth and detailing. According to the Kavadiyas, the origin of Kavad storytelling tradition is attributed to the mythological story of Shravan Kumar from Ramayana, who carried his blind parents in a Kavad to various pilgrim spots but was accidentally killed by King Dashrath. Since Shravan was unable to complete the task of taking his parents to all the holy spots, the Kavadiyas carry on the tradition of bringing the pilgrim spots to the people in the form of the Kavad shrine. Due to this belief, the date of Kavad practice dates back to 2nd century BCE. Kavad is suffering in the modern age due to the lack of patrons and economic support, lack of audience, and the decreased popularity of the old stories of epics. In current times of economic difficulties and struggle, Kavadiyas and Kavad makers are adopting Kavads to modern stories, social issues such as Meena Ki Kahani, which is on girl-child education, the prevention measures of COVID-19 pandemic, and continuing the art of storytelling. The significance of intangible cultural heritage is not limited to the cultural manifestation itself, but is rather the knowledge and skills that are permitted and being transferred from one generation to the next. Thus, safeguarding an intangible cultural heritage such as Kavad is important. The genealogies maintained by the Kavadiyas is an important source to study the regional history of Rajasthan. The socio-economic value of this transmission of knowledge, myths, stories is relevant to the minority groups of Sutas and Kavadiya Bhats and the major social groups in a state.